Today I'm making Vietnamese sweet and sour fish soup. It's very satisfying and delicious. Everybody loves this dish. My father, he was the fish dealer and he knows everything about fish, and he made sure that we Vietnamese girls, daughters in the house know how to make it when we grown up. So if you interested of to know how I make them, please come to the kitchen with me. I will show you how. Welcome to Saigon Cook Travel. I am Saigon Cook. Normally we use the snackhead fish in Vietnam, but I am in America and my neighbor Scott recently went fishing and he gave me this red fish, or you can call it a red bass. The meat similar to a snackhead fish. Just like every Vietnamese, we don't waste anything, so I use the head today. The head has bones, but beside the bones where the meats are, the meats are very delicious. So beside the fish, I have the tun, the long vegetable there, pineapple, bean sprout. The red one there is the rhubarb. I use the toughness of rhubarb to do the sour part of the dish. I also have okra and tomato. So the rhubarb I already cut up and cook it so that I can get the toughness liquid from the rhubarb. Now the tun, I remove, I peel all the skin off and cut up on the back, the damaged parts, and only use the good one. Remember that this vegetable, they are on the ground, so it might be might have dirt in the middle there, so make sure you clean well. So the method of making the vegetable here, I cut them into piece bite-sized pieces, the same as okra. The order of going in the soup will be okra, tomato, okra, tun, and finally will be bean sprout. Before that is pineapples. All the vegetables will make difference. You need to fry all of them. If you miss anything, it won't make a sweet and sour typical or authentic. You can omit the bean sprout, or you can omit the pineapple, but the full version, authentic version, includes everything that I have today. So for the tomato, I wash it from Adams, and I also cut into small pieces. The small pieces will go in the pot first to make the broth more flavorful and colorful. Will be reddish color from the tomato. Now for the pineapple, I cut off a few slices and I cut off the skin. Very easy if you just go around this way, and you can follow me. I show you how to remove on the dot. On those dots, on the pineapple is they will be tough to chew, so make sure you clean them well. When we were in Vietnam, the dealer who sell pineapple, they have very very sharp knife, and they cut the pineapple like a paper. It's so fast and so efficient. So here you can see I still have some dot to remove. The way they do this is you cut a V between the dot, and you remove the dot very easily. Remember, you cut a V. Okay, so now I have a piece ready to go. I also cut into slices, just by side pieces, and well, that will be fine. I like to take opportunity to thank you for visiting my channel today. I'm glad you're here with me, because you are the reason I'm here. I like to share what I know about cooking, baking, and everything in between. It's my pleasure to share what I know. Before I love cooking and baking. I was learning cooking very early in my years, and attended many classes for baking and baking and cooking. So now I feel that I like to share them with you. So please subscribe to my channel so that I got encouragement from you. And if you have any question, please write down at the comment section below, and I will answer them. I promise. You can ask me anything, and if I don't know, I will find the answer. So, like I said before, I show you the rhubarb that I also cut small, cut into small pieces, and I cook them with water, and I will use the water to tuck, to make the broth sour. That is the reason they. So I can stop here. I show you here. This is the vegetable. This is a green onion I grow in the garden, and the other one I just show you right there is I don't know what to call in English, but in Vietnam it's ngò ôm. Ngò, normally we call coriander, but you just see the leaves of that vegetable, of that herb, and you recognize it, and you say that if you go to the Asian market, you want to buy them, you just say, I want to cook a sweet and sour soup, and I want the herbs to get in, to put at the end of the cooking, and they will know what that is. So like I said before, I cook the tomatoes small first, and in some piece of the core of the pineapple, and a few pieces of pineapple inside, so that I make the broth flavorful. And now the water pretty hot, so I put the fish head in to cook it now. And you keep it cooked like 15-20 minutes, depends on your fish. Is it big, you cook more, but for my fish head, I cook 15 minutes. And the way I tested it, I just pop the chopstick and it go through easily. That means it's cooked. So now I get the fish out onto this display bowl. Now for the broth, at this point you can strain the broth and add the new vegetables. The new vegetable will go into the final product. You see, I put the tuna, the okra, the pineapple, the tomato in now. And this need, it doesn't take long to cook them. I just want to cook for a few minutes. You can see that the last minute I add the tuna and the bean sprout. Those need very fast to cook. When the water boiling, you add in and stir, and that's it. 1 minute you can turn up the heat now. And I can season the soup now. I season it just with some fish sauce, some salt, ground black pepper, and in the cup you saw earlier, that was my lime juice to enforce the darkness of the rhubarb. So I taste that the soup now is perfect. So I turn up the heat and I will add the vegetables right now. Like I said before, the green onion, the barilla leaves, the ngò om, the coriander om. So now it's time to present the fish and the soup. So the fish already out in the bowl. Now I scoop more vegetable and into the bowl, and I can play it here and there so that it show the red, the yellow, the red of tomato, the yellow of pineapple, the green of tuna and okra and other herbs. And finally, the broth all over, because this soup is good with everything. The broth is good, the vegetable crunchy, the fish is sweet, it's very good. So I make a flour, a little flour from that chili, and I put on top for looking good. And I also have some shallot chips. So shallot chip with some oil, some flavor oil from cooking shallot. So that soup is perfect now. And I think I make my father proud. I got it. I managed to cook the very good soup, delicious soup that I can be proud to present and to invite everyone eating my soup. And I invite you to the table with me. We taste it and enjoy. Thank you for watching. I hope I inspire you to cook this dish for your family. Please like, share my channel and subscribe. Bye bye.